Okay, welcome to Bedford Common. I'm Ralph Hammond, and we are interviewing all the candidates for the upcoming election on March 9th. And our guest right now is Chris Gittens. Chris, welcome to Bedford Common, and we wish you luck on the election, and we wish you luck on what you're going to present right now.
All right. Ralph, thank you for having me. I'm Chris Gittens, candidate for Selectman. Thank you for taking the time to watch, and to Bedford TV for creating this video. I have deep roots in Bedford. Almost 20 years ago, I moved here into the house that my grandparents built in 1951. My father was a member of the first graduating class at Bedford High School in 1958. I'm fortunate to still live in the house that my grandparents built, but now with my wife and two children. Our kids are benefiting from Bedford's great schools, our daughter at Lane, and our son at Davis. In addition to excellent schools, we have safe neighborhoods, welcoming neighbors, and thriving businesses. I don't take all these good things for granted. I'm committed to sustaining our strong foundations while building a better future. The three foundations of my candidacy are community, climate, and connectivity. My vision for Bedford's, for future Bedford builds upon our strong foundations. The first C is community. I'm committed to supporting public goods, which improve our quality of life, such as our library, our schools, our Council on Aging, and Springsbrook Park. To further strengthen our community, let's expand our housing options for those for whom Bedford has become harder to afford, in particular, young people, families looking for a starter home, and seniors. The second C is climate. Reducing greenhouse gas emissions, building resiliency to climate change, and improving energy efficiency are core issues for me. I see the world through the eyes of my children, and I have no greater responsibility to ensure that future generations inherit a livable climate from us. We've substantially reduced our carbon footprint at home, but we need to also act locally. My vision for Bedford's future includes carbon-neutral buildings, 80% reduction in greenhouse gas emissions, and infrastructure improvements to build our resilience to climate change. Finally, the third C is connectivity. Good connectivity between neighborhoods and between Bedford and surrounding towns strengthens our community and improves our quality of life. I'll advocate for infrastructure improvements to make it easier and more appealing to bike and walk around town. I'll work with state and regional organizations to improve transportation options and to reduce pass-through traffic. Locally, Bedford needs to make evidence-based decisions when it comes to road improvements and traffic mitigation. For example, we need to investigate and understand what went wrong with the rework of Old Billerica Road, Burlington Road intersection, so that next time we get the desired outcome. Good leaders plan for the future while also learning from the past. On Saturday, March 9th, I ask for your help to lead Bedford into the future. We have tremendous amount of creativity, goodwill, and ability to solve tough problems. Let's apply them to achieve our vision for Bedford's future. Together, we can build a better Bedford. Again, thank you to Bedford TV and its staff for making this opportunity possible.
Thank you, Chris. This is very good, and we look forward to your visiting at Candidates Night and at the elections on March 9th.
Thank you much, Ralph.
Yep.